Okay, welcome back. Let's start again. So our next speaker is Professor Adamyan. I'm not sure if I pronounced
Yeah,
it
very
correctly. Yeah.
correct.
Yeah, more or less. Okay, so please, thank you very much. I think
Thank
your
you.
slides are already ready. You're welcome to start. Thank you.
I want to thank Professor Petrucciani for kind invitation to have talk. And I will speak about quantum Hall effect and Shubnikov-Dehaas effect. You probably know these effects in so great material, two-dimensional, one-layer material. It is graphene within non-Markovian Langevin approach. So you can see my co-authors, and they are from Боголюбов Laboratory of Theoretical Physics. First of all, I will have a small introduction. I will speak about quantum Hall effect and Shubnikov-Dehaas effect. And third one is calculation and discussions. Little bit about thermal conductivity and conclusions. So one of fascinating topic in fundamental physics, or in condensed matter physics, one can say, this is investigation of two-dimensional materials or two-dimensional electron cars in magnetic field or electric field at very low temperature. This is microkelvin, millikelvin, and about Kelvin region. So I will speak about electric conductivity or resistivity and the charge carrier in such two-dimensional system is significantly high, especially in graphene. For example, in graphene, the mobility, electron mobility, about two orders of magnitude larger than in other two-dimensional systems, two-dimensional electron gas. So in heterostructure, for example, or in black phosphorus or other materials. So it is very, very special, unique material in this sense. And there are a lot of theory models, but it's still this galvanomagnetic effects in this system are not completely understood. People not completely understood. And because of this, we suggested model to describe conductivity or Hall effect or Shubnikov effect in graphene. The idea is very simple, so charge carrier are considered as a quantum particle or collective system, which is coupled to the thermal bath or to environment, heat bath, or in other words, through particle phonon interaction. And environment, because in graphene there are other, except electrons, there are other particles, yeah, for example, nuclei, carbon, for example, or other some defect, impurities, and other things. And also this graphene, it is one layer but it is lying on some substrate. So in this sense, substrate is also belongs to environment of such system. And dynamic of charge carriers is restricted by the average collision time, or time for free motion of charge carriers or electrons in graphene. This is the second simple idea of this model. And one body and two body effects are also effectively included, and non-Markovian effects are effectively included because we use non-Markovian, for example, stochastic approach. So geometry such two-dimensional system or any dimension, not only graphene, is the following. So we have environment. This is our collective system or system of electrons, charge carriers. We have perpendicular to this plane uniform magnetic field. And also in this plane, we have along, for example, X axis, electric field. So we use uniform or constant magnetic field perpendicular to the plane. And perpendicular, so along the Z axis. And for such system, so we have collective system, it is charge carrier, plus environment. It is ensemble of heat bus. And this system, collective subsystem, plus heat bus, Hamiltonian, one can write in the following way. So this is our collective Hamiltonian for free motion of electron. And this electron embedded in the uniform magnetic field. This is vector potential of this field, magnetic field, and constant electric field along X axis. So all these things related with collective system. We have system of harmonic oscillators, which imitates the environment of heat bus. This term, this is interaction between collective system, charge particle, and heat bus system. B plus, B minus is this creation and aggregation operators of our heat bus. This is a counter term which console appearance of potential, coupling potential due to the coupling of collective system with heat bus. Here is written, you see, this is our vector potential. It is convenient go from this Px, Py momenta to new momenta in this way, where omega is x defined through magnetic field and effective mass along x-axis, This is for along the Y axis. And omega C is simply cyclotron frequency. So one can rewrite our Hamiltonian, initial Hamiltonian, then in this way. One can obtain Heisenberg equation for collective variables, yeah, for x, y, px, and py. Yeah, simple commuting, yeah, this operator with our Hamiltonian. Yeah. And the same one can done. Also, one can write equation of motion or Heisenberg equation for bus variable. Yeah, for B plus and B. And the one can, this is because our Hamiltonian is quadratic, one can solve analytically equations motion for bus variable. And solution of this equation one can put in this equation. Yeah, B plus and B. And so. So if we do this, we get nonlinear integral differential stochastic dissipative equation. Yeah. This is for coordinates. This is for momenta. It is integral differential. It is clear why we have differential and also we have integrals in this equation. Why? Non-linear, because this, you see, we have integration not from zero to infinity, but from zero from given time t. So in this sense, this equation non-linear. This integral part connected with dissipation, and k alpha g, k g are the dissipation kernels. And F alpha and Fg are stochastic forces or random forces in this equation. And this operator for stochastic forces in coordinates, yeah, because they are in the equation for momentum, depends on the initial coordinate of all bus variables, P plus B. Yeah? So in this sense, bus, these random forces are fluctuation because of uncertainties of initial condition of environment. So it is usual method to statistical mechanics to get random forces or inversibility in such type equation. So this random forces have Gaussian distributions with zero average. And this P plus and P phi in stochastic force have Bose-Einstein statistic, because for heat bus we use bosonic operator. Here you can see the shape of dissipative kernels. Yeah. And alpha weight is k coupling constant between collective system and heat bus. This equation for collective variable, one can solve analytically using Laplace transform. It is also a standard method in statistical physics. And solution looks in the following way. Yeah, it is for x coordinate. You see this x0, p0, it is initial. This values at time zero. It depends on some coefficient, which depends on time, where these values also depends on this coefficient and stochastic random force. This coefficient looks in the following way, not so simple, but analytical. When we do integration in inverse Laplace transform, we use this residue theorem, and the roots, appears because of this, apply this residue theorem, and for roots we should solve the following equation. If we know solution, we can take derivative in time. And average system over whole system, averaging all operators over whole system, entire system. And we can get for average values differential equation. But again, it is nonlinear, because coefficients of this equation depends on time. This omega tilde c y, omega tilde c x, depends on time. And these values, alpha p x, alpha p y, depends on time. And also this electric fields in x direction and in y direction depends on time. Here, effectively, this is lambda p x, friction coefficients. This is a renormalized cyclotron frequencies. One can define this friction coefficient through this coefficient of solution of Langevin Heisenberg equation for collective variables. You see this is point, it is derivative in time. Renormalized cyclotron frequency, one can find in the following way. Also, the renormalized electric fields in x direction and y direction, one can find in the following way. And you can see that initially we have only electric field in x degrees of freedom, in x axis. But during the evolution, dynamics of system appears electric field in y axis. Yeah, this way. Okay, so we study the magnetotransport process in the system, in this two-dimensional system. You can see this is, one can write equation for current density in the following, in following type. Yeah, it is by definition. Here is not I, but it should be summation over G. So this is sigma, this electric conductivity tensor, which depends on magnetic field. And here G is electric field, yeah, initial in the system. But the current density one can write through the derivative of coordinate also in the following way. Using this both equation, finally one can get the current density component, x and y component, through the solution of our equation of for collective system. Yeah, this is C3 and D3. For another direction of electric field, so initially we have this field, one can change to such type field, that electric field we have in y direction, and so we can write also in this case x and y component for current density. Yeah, and so one can write also through this solution of collective variable through the coefficients of solution of collective variable z3 tilde and z3. So finally we can write expression for the conductivity. Yeah, this is with two-dimensional system, so we have matrix 2 by 2. One can make some inverse transformation of this matrix. One, we can get resistance tensor. Again, one can write this resistance tensor through this coefficient of solution for collective variables, for charge carrier. Yeah. Non-diagonal element of this matrix of specific magnetoresistant tensors have meaning so-called Hall resistance. In the literature, calls it this Hall resistance. In our variables, Hall resistance looks in the following way. One can write in the following way. So we come again to the model. And we should make some additional assumptions to describe the electric magnetic properties of, for example, graphene or any two-dimensional system, heterostructure, for example. So, and in such model, we have three type characteristic times. It is relaxation time, which is related with friction coefficient. in moment. Yeah. For simplicity, we assume that our system or thermal bus is atropic, so lambda x or lambda equal are equal to each other. Yeah. Then instead of two times, we have one time. So this is relaxation time. Inverse of lambda, of friction coefficient. Another time we introduce, this is average time between two collisions. So this is tau. So this is related with free motion of charge carrier, this time. Time of free motion, one can say, or time of free pass. This relaxation time and this collision time, of course, depends on temperature, carrier density, magnetic field, or other field in systems. There is other field. And this tau air and tau are related with one body, or in other words, this mean field effect. Tau is related with two body effects. So it comes in reality, it comes from our knowledge of nuclear physics. In nuclear physics, in heavy ion collision, we have two body friction and one body friction. In collision, two heavy ions, for example. So this comes from our side, from nuclear physics. The third time is this memory time. So this is inverse gamma of heat bus excitation. It is related with the fact that collective system and heat bus not interact with infinite speed, but with some infinite, during the some infinite time. So this taken into account through this gamma. And next, so this is we have three characteristic time. And we assume the strongest assumption of this model is the following, that in each collision, charge carrier, the charge carrier loses its ordered motion. Yeah? And its velocity or momentum becomes equal to zero. This is strong assumption, which also we took from there are such approximation in statistical physics. So in this sense, in all our equations or in all our coefficients, for example, of solution of collective coordinates, is limited by the following condition. Time is equal to the tau. So time of average time between two collisions. Three pies. So all these times are the same for all charge carriers in collisions. And so they, in this way, they appear in all these coefficients R1, R2, C3, D3, which are in this resistivity matrix tensor or this conductivity tensor. To obtain clear physics picture of the process, we use space symmetric system, not only for environment, lambda x equal to lambda y, but also for collective system, mx equal to my, and respectively the cyclotron frequency are the same. So we have one cyclotron. So all equation for the roots are simplified, and one can get analytical solution of this equation. Yeah, you see, it depends on cyclotron frequency, this gamma, which is related with memory, and friction, lambda. One can even simplify this solution by expanding this equation up to the first order over lambda divided by gamma. Usually gamma, this memory time is much larger than friction coefficient, especially for this, for such system where mobility is very high. So in this approximation, we can get analytical expression for diagonal conductivity and for non-diagonal of diagonal conductivity. Yeah? You see, it is very simple. In some sense, very simple expression, which depends on memory time, this average collision time, relaxation time, cyclotron frequency, and that is all. Yeah. This is one can go to Markovian limit. Yeah? So gamma approach to infinity. So in this limit, the expression are even simple. So in Markovian limit, we can, and when the time, relaxation time, or collision time, average collision time, much larger than relaxation time, gamma equal to infinity. So we get the simple Drude model, which we know from statistical physics. Yeah, this is simple Drude model where this sigma x zero is the following. This n is concentration. This is charge number of charge carrier. This is relaxation time. Yeah, this is mass of charge carrier. And when so this we get in this condition, and at condition when magnetic field is equal, strength of magnetic field is equal to zero. So one can say we got some general form of Drude conductivity, or we generalize this Drude model by by including memory effects, for example, yeah, and would introducing average collision time and so on. So it, because of this, you can see, so we have non-oscillated term and oscillated term, yeah? This non-oscillated term are related with Drude model. And now in our case, because of finite average collision time, we get some oscillator term in this equation for diagonal and non-diagonal. And you can, after we will see that these terms are very important for describing of two-dimensional material. To go to some calculations, we we go from these times to another variable from average by multiplying this time, for example, this is inverse average collision time by the ratio mass to charge. Because in this case, we get simply, this is simply mobility of system, measurable variable. Yeah. Here in this case, we get strength of magnetic field, also observable variable. Yeah. And some gamma, which is connected with memory time. So in this sense, it's better always better go to very to parameters which are measurable in experiment. So for graphene, we know also that for graphene, mobility of charge carrier depends on magnetic field, but very weakly one can say not there is no dependence on temperature up to temperature 100 Kelvin, so 0 to 100 Kelvin. And also we can say from experimental data the mobility does not depend on very weakly depends on temperature and on magnetic field. And so this mobility we took from experimental data. We don't calculate mobility, we take simply from experimental data. So this is a calculation. This is resistivity, diagonal component as function of magnetic field. Yeah. This is in units of ohm. This is Tesla. At present, one can in laboratory produce magnetic field up to 35 Tesla, right? It's a huge number. So here is up to 9 Tesla experimental data. And here is solid line experimental dependence. The dashed line of different color related with our calculation. This calculation. And so when here is non-diagonal resistivity again is function of magnetic strengths or solid line experiment, dashed line, different colors are theory. You can see that agreement, so here electron mobility, we know from experimental data. The following is written here. The concentration for system, we know also from experimental data. And temperature of graphene in this case about 30 millikelvin. And you can see the description are more or less good. It's up to strength of magnetic field about 3 Tesla, we have Shubnikov-Dehaas oscillation, which is here. And after this 3 Tesla, we have some quantum Hall behavior. In quantum Hall, you see non-diagonal term have at some fields have plateaus. Yeah? For example, here about 3 Tesla, 4 and 6 Tesla we have plateau, also from 7 to 8 or 9 Tesla we have plateau. And at the center of plateau, this diagonal term is usually equal to minimum, to zero. And diagonal term between the plateau are maximum. This maxima belongs to this region between two plateaus. This maxima belongs to between two plateaus here. Yeah? So we see, so it is really whole, by definition, it is whole effect. But to describe this experimental data, we should extract the time, average time of collision time. And what we found, that collision time, or here is, because relaxation time, this tau r, constant, this material does not depend on magnetic field, is constant. So this is dependence of collision time. So you can see the collision time decreases with increasing magnetic field. Yeah? This is for Shubnikov-Dehaz case up to 3 Tesla. And this is for quantum Hall case. We see that about 3 Tesla, some fast transition appears in system. So this ratio have discontinuity. So this ratio for Shubnikov-Dehaz have practically about 1.5 point, but for quantum effect is more than 4. But the dependence functional form are the same. Only here this time decrease more faster than in this case. Because we can also calculate the velocity of charge carrier as function of magnetic field. Yeah? We have model, we can make any calculation of different observable, different quantities. And so you can see for low magnetic field, we have smooth decrease of velocity. So it is in the case of Shubnikov-Dehaz oscillations. In quantum Hall effect case, you can see the velocity have step-like function. So we have some, and in this, for this magnetic field, usually X component of velocity much less than Y component of velocity. So in this case, one can say this is Y component of velocity divided by velocity speed of light in vacuum. And so this V, so this transverse velocity of charge carrier has stepwise behavior. So in some case, this velocity of momentum quantized. So this is another example of, or another sample of graphene at different, at another conditions. for example, for different temperature, for diagonal component of resistivity, and for non-diagonal component of resistivity. This is Shubnikov effect, and you can see dependence. The again, dashed line are theory, solid line are experimental data. And you can see that description is quite good. And also we predict the behavior for non-diagonal element. Usually experimentalist gives only diagonal resistivity or conductivity. And we see that this non-diagonal element also oscillates and has somehow some plateau structure, and the behavior becomes smoother with increasing of temperature. So this resistivity is getting smoother with increasing temperature. T0 is temperature from 1.5 to 50 Kelvin. The different temperature have different, slightly different this ratio collision time to relaxation time. So practically they're similar. You can see one can describe the experimental data for diagonal component. This is another sample for experimental data for another sample of graphene. It is Shubnikov de Haas oscillations example. So this is mobility smaller than the previous cases, relatively smaller. Concentration also different, and temperature is not micro Kelvin, about 10 Kelvin. So you can see again experimental theory and also our prediction for non-diagonal conductivity. What is interesting in this case that for non-diagonal conductivity, even not non-diagonal, but for oscillating part term, oscillating term of non-diagonal resistivity, we have some plateaus also at some magnetic field, like in the case of quantum Hall effect. So this is our, one can say, prediction. In large scale, this oscillating term have very small amplitude, and so in the when we show the non-diagonal term, all sum of oscillating, non-oscillating part of resistivity. Yeah, it is difficult to observe these plateaus here. Yeah? So experimentalists should somehow extract this linear dependence on this oscillatory dependence of non-diagonal resistivity. So again, you can see that the ratio between collision time and relaxation time decreases with magnetic field. The same behavior for other conditions for material. And you can also be, I didn't tell you, but you can see that this ratio, it is too, at higher magnetic field approach to unity, or a little bit smaller than unity. But at small magnetic field, it is about 3, 4, 5, yeah? So in this sense, these times are comparable. Comparable time. And because of this, we have oscillation in this conductivity, so resistivity. And in this sense, it looks that this all oscillation have transient behavior, transitional behavior. They are simply transitional effects, which we know from examples in school books or university books, transient effects or transitional. So it was something new for us to understand. Another example, experimental data, it is usually measure the resistivity, diagonal term, as function of concentration or charge density in this graphene. Charge density, charge carriers, so electrons. And you can see this is also very nice behavior here, experimentally, for example. So you have some oscillations with concentration here. And here you have again this stepwise function. So plateaus sum, it's some for non-diagonal conductivity. Now you can see between two plateaus, you have this maximum. At the middle of plateau, this is diagonal part, yet diagonal resistivity is minimal one. Again, for mobility, we know experimental data, dependence mobility on charge concentration. Yeah? We simply took this experimental data and parameterized by the following function. So this experimental experiment done at fixed magnetic field, about 40 Tesla, and temperature was 4 Kelvin. And you can see that our calculation, dashed line, more or less good describe all this behavior. If again, we go to this ratio between collision time to relaxation time, you can see it grows with concentration, yeah, practically linear growth. And again, these numbers are comparable. It's 2, 4, 6. Not much difference between these two times, different time. At the same time, you see experimental mobility is decreases with increasing concentration. This is experimental data. We can also calculate velocity component in x-axis direction. Yeah? Here is root, this is ratio of velocity component, x component to the speed of light as function of concentration. And also this is y component. Huh? Y component. Y component. And you can see again this Y component, like in previous case, dependence of Y component on magnetic field has stepwise behavior. Yeah. So transfer velocity somehow in this case one can say for momentum. Transverse momentum is quantized. Yeah, it is written for this component, transverse component for density current density on function of concentration. And so you can see it also has step-like behavior. This is again another example of magneto resistance, so diagonal, longitudinal resistivity, and non-diagonal resistivity as function of magnetic field. It is done. It is done not for graphene, for heterostructure. It is gallium, very popular heterostructure. Heterostructure is gallium arsenide. You know this. The people got some Nobel Prize for such experiment. And so you can see again this Shubnikov-Dehaas effect here at smaller strengths of magnetic field. At higher magnetic field, they observe quantum Hall effect. Yeah, here for diagonal, and here this plateaus for non-diagonal resistivity. So, and we go again to this ratio of times. In this case, for heterostructure, you can see their behavior the same, like for graphene. No much difference between behavior of this quantity on material. So you can see there again, these two values, average collision time and relaxation time, are comparable. Yeah, again, orders of 4, 3, 2, 1. Yeah. And also you can see this fast transition from at about 1.5 Tesla. Yeah, here is Shubnikov-Dehaas oscillation. Here is for quantum Hall effect. And so for heterostructure and for graphene, one can compare these ratios for these two cases. Here is, you can see it is for comparison are given in this plot, or all these values, previous and that one. For dashed line, it is for graphene, solid line for heterostructure. Yeah. And the same for, this is for Shubnikov effect, the Dehaas effect, and here for quantum Hall effect. You can see that only difference that for Shubnikov Dehaas, this ratio slightly larger. Yeah. But the behavior, the rate of decrease, yeah, practically similar. And for Shubnikov-Dehaas effect and for quantum Hall effect. So this model one can also generalize to describe thermal conductivity. Yeah. Instead of gradient of electric field, we have gradient of temperature in the, for example, along the x-axis. And one can calculate this tensor for thermal conductivity. And here is written the heat bus. One can write in the following way. This is concentration. This is average kinetic energy of charge carrier for carriers of heat. So we assume that the same ability of carriers to carry charge and transport heat, they are the same object. The same object are responsible for both. The same carrier responsible for both processes. So, doing the same like for church, career, for thermal conductivity, one can obtain this tensor for thermal conductivity. Yeah, it contains this conductivity tensor. This is average kinetic energy. This is charge of carrier. And one can show analytically that at high temperature, so Markovian limit, so in other words, and at when the average collision times becomes is equal to infinity, we can get so the formula, the classical formula, Wiedemann-Franz law for so-called Lorentz number L. So this ratio, this is thermal conductivity, is electric conductivity, and this T0 is temperature. So this value is constant. But you remember that our tau is finite. It's order of 1, 2, 3, 4, not infinity. So in this sense, we have violation of this Wiedemann-Franz law at low temperatures for this two-dimensional material. So it in reality, it was observed experimentally, the violation of this law for graphene or other material. So we calculate this thermal conductivity component, diagonal, non-diagonal as function of magnetic field for graphene at temperature 10 Kelvin, and mobility, the following mobility, not so high mobility. And you can see the smooth dependence of this. And quantities, these quantities are in the range which people obtain for thermal conductivity in the middle, intermediate range. So comes to final section conclusion. So the galvano thermomagnetic effects strongly depends on the relationship or interplay between relaxation time and average collision time. The values of relaxation and collision times are comparable. Thus, the Shubnikov-Dehaas oscillation quantum Hall effect as a result of transitional process. This is new in this sense. And know anything, so you can see practically classical equation we use for this charge carrier. Yeah. We introduce some assumption that collision time is fixed and in average the same for all charge carriers. Of course, this is very strong. But we can describe this galvanomagnetic or galvanic properties of graphene. No assuming any massless fermion, Dirac fermion, or other such very such abstract things. Only classical type equation and some simple assumption, which is one can think at least logically to understand. So quantum, what we found that quantum Hall effect, the transfer velocity, momentum quantized, and transfer current as step-like function of magnetic field and charge density concentration. Plateau-like behavior was predicted for off-diagonal resistance. I didn't show examples for thermal conductivity, but we found in some sense also plateaus in this behavior, like for resistivity or conductivity. Yeah? And in some sense, they are correlate with each other. It should be so, the same material. It's the same properties. So we see the same, we can, with the same model, describe graphene and other two-dimensional material. I show examples of this gallium arsenide heterostructure. So I'm finished. Thank you. Thank you for your attention.
Yeah, thank you very much for the very detailed talk. Other questions? Maybe a quick one, because we're running a little bit out of time. Sean?
Thank you for the talk. It was slide 16, you refer to one-body, two-body effects. You don't have to go to the slide, just a quick one. And you are referring to phenomena in high-energy physics. Are you referring to the viscosity at... you know, using relativistic fluid dynamics?
I refer, you mean this one body and two body viscosity, yeah? It is in heavy ion collisions, we know. Yeah, at low, relatively low energy, so intermediate energies. We know such examples, such description.
Okay, other
it is 10 MeV per nucleon, 15 MeV per nucleon, if it is saying something.
Okay, if there are no other urgent questions, we should thank Professor Adamyan again. Thank you very much.